Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to another video book review on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum, and today the book we're taking a look at is Weapon Mounts for Secondary Armaments. Very sort of stoic sounding title. This is a book that has actually a pretty interesting history on its own. This is kind of similar to Colonel Chin's book on the machine gun, in that this was originally created by government contract. It was commissioned by the Detroit Arsenal as a reference guide for designers who needed to create new secondary weapons mounts for new vehicles and machine guns. So when it says secondary armament, what it's generally talking about almost always are machine guns. So if you have a tank with a 75 millimeter gun, its secondary armament is one or a whole bunch of machine guns. If you have an aircraft, perhaps it has bombs and a cannon, and its secondary mounts are gun pods. And in addition to vehicles, this also covers, and perhaps the most direct practical application for people today, this covers tripods and mounting pintles for machine guns. This whole book covers not just American equipment, but basically everything the US government had been able to get its hands on by 1957. So it covers pretty much all of Europe, covers a lot of Japanese equipment. The one place where it's a little bit weak is Russian. It does cover Russian stuff up to the end of World War II, but after that it gets a little sketchy. They didn't have, Russia wasn't sending over a lot of equipment samples for the US Ordnance Corps to take a look at in 1957. At any rate, the book comes in at a rather substantial 1,157 pages. It is huge, and it covers like literally everything that the government was able to get their hands on. Tanks, aircraft, machine gun mounts. Now, when it was originally written, they published, printed something like 25 copies of it. This is very typical government contracting expense account. I wouldn't quite say boondoggle, but this book, I'm sure, cost an incredible amount of money for the government to create, and they didn't do a whole lot with it. Well, fast forward about 50 years, and the guys at Long Mountain Ordnance, now Phoenix Defense, found it and discovered that they knew the person who still had the original manuscript, basically. And they got to looking at this and realized these books were incredibly expensive, like $1,000 a copy for originals, but they had a tremendous amount of valuable information for collectors, not just machine gun collectors, but also anyone interested in armored vehicles, light armored vehicles, trucks, aircraft, military restoration sort of stuff. And so they decided to go ahead, buy the manuscript, and have it reprinted. And that's what we have here, is the 2007 reprint. And I want to read something out here. The special thanks section at the very beginning here really is a total who's who of people in the machine gun community. So special thanks for making this reprint a reality to Bob Ferris, Dolph Goldsmith, John Moran, Tom Nelson, Bob Siegel, Dan Shea, Herb Wooden in memoriam, he was curator of the pattern room, William Valorand in memoriam, and Hank Visser in memoriam. So like any book endorsed by those people is a book that I will go out of my way to find a copy of. Now, this is again primarily of use for people into machine guns, tanks, or aircraft, which is a kind of a small group. I would have said, you know, if you're looking at mounted machine guns, you know, the whole Browning family, there's a lot of really valuable information in here that you just won't find anywhere else. There's, in fact, one page in here that is just a comparison of pins. So like the plunger pins that you use to hold, say, the rear mount of a Browning machine gun onto a pintle, there's like a dozen different versions of them that were used in different applications. And here we have a page that shows all of them side by side, what their assembly numbers are, how they were described, and what they look like. That's, you know, one of these little trivial pieces of information that's just impossible to find anywhere else. And that's the sort of stuff that this book is full of. Now, if you're not specifically interested in machine gun stuff, if you're a tank person, to my eye, and I'm not hugely deep into tanks, but there's a tremendous amount of just really cool visual material here on tanks. This book covers everything going back to World War I, and it includes, because it was everything that the US government Ordnance Corps had, it includes a huge number of experimental stuff. So all sorts of funky looking experimental tanks, especially experimental American stuff, and machine guns too. There's pictures of things like Robinson machine guns in here on their original tripods, because the tripod. There's a, you know, a major section of this is tripods, ground mounts, pintle mounts, ball mounts, all that sort of stuff. Yeah, it's a smorgasbord of interesting, cool information. So this is a book that I'm quite sure once it's finally sold out, and it's been in print for 12 years now, so I think they're starting to get close to the end of the supply. It probably will not get reprinted because it is a very specialist sort of book. However, almost 1,200 pages, price is $70, available on Amazon through Phoenix Defense, through Chipotle Publishing. I'll have a link in the description text below where you can order up a copy yourself if you're interested. I think it's a great piece of reference material. Obviously, it's not for everyone, but I think the cost to benefit, just of being able to flip through and look at pictures of funky, weird tanks and experimental machine guns and such, that makes it worthwhile to me. So anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Check it out if it's your thing. Thanks for watching.